Okay, so for you, it's got complete already. You got completed with the introduction, right? So I'm going to take the very smaller topic of the entire system. Okay, so the topic is ear. So I will be starting with the lesser topic only. So this was the ear. So in the ear, we have the three parts majorly coming into this picture. So this part we call it as outer ear. You can able to mute it. So you please mute it. If you have any doubt, just unmute and ask the question. Okay. So this was the entire ear. So this ear is divided into three parts. One is external ear. External ear will start from this here to here. So this we call it as tympanic membrane. From here to here, we call it as external ear. And this part we call it as middle ear. So this entire part is middle ear. And this entire part we call it as inner ear. So external ear, middle ear, and internal ear. Let's see each part one by one and what is its functions and how the sound will be propagated from outside the air to till the ear. So how we will sense what type of the sound. For example, we can know it is the ringing the bell or it is dog barking or someone is calling us. How this final sense of the sound we can able to understand, we are going to see today. Okay, introduction. Auditory system has three main components, as I told you already, outer, middle, and inner ears. So all which work together to transfer sounds from environment to the brain. So first one is outer ear. In the outer ear, we have the very importantly the three parts. So whatever we see this outer ear, we call it as pinna. So I'll show you the parts mainly and later on. So this we call it as pinna. So this is made up of elastic cartilage. Okay, so this is pinna. So it can able to bend. And this canal we call it as external auditory canal. And this is tympanic membrane. So pinna, external auditory canal, and tympanic membrane. So these are the three parts of the external ear. Okay, and this is the middle ear. So in this middle ear, you have three bones, malleus, incus, and stapes. These three bones together we call it as ear ossicles. And this is Eustachian tube. Okay, and this entire thing we call it as labyrinthine apparatus. In the labyrinthine apparatus, we have the semicircular canals, and this is cochlea. This is vestibular apparatus, and this is cochlea. Okay, let's see in detail. So, pinna, which is concave and cartilaginous structure made up of elastic cartilage. So, what the use of that pinna is, it mainly directs the sound waves towards the external auditory canal. So, ear canal. Ear canal is like a tube which is starting from the pinna and ending till the tympanic membrane. So, it was around 1.25 inches long and 0.25 inches diameter. So, it was actually located in the temporal bone. So, in the facial bone, in the skull bones, you have a bone called temporal bone. In that temporal bone only, this auditory canal will be there. And outer one-third of the canal is cartilage. And its shape will be twisted or elongated S-shape. So the ear canal directs the airborne sound waves towards the tympanic membrane. So the ear canal resonates. Actually, why do we have an ear canal is, it will transfer the sound waves into loudness. It will increase the loudness to 3000 to 4000 hertz. So, which is also called the frequency. It will increase the frequency of waves. And next, tympanic membrane. Tympanic membrane, we also call it as ear drum. So, which is division between the middle ear and the outer ear. So, it was actually the gray pinkish color. So, when the person is healthy, the tympanic membrane has three thin layers. And coming to the next thing, so this is pinna. We call it as pinna or auricle. Auricle or pinna, both are same. So, and this is external auditory canal. So, this is external auditory canal or external auditory meatus, both are same. and this is tympanic membrane. And coming to the next thing, middle ear cavity. The middle ear cavity located in the mastoid bone. You can also see the mastoid bone very easily. If you touch behind your ear, the back side of your ear, you can feel the hard bony like prominence. That is actually mastoid process. In that only we have the middle ear. So the middle ear will start from the tympanic membrane and ends till the inner ear. And it was approximately 2 cubic centimeters in volume. And inside the middle ear, we have the mucous membrane. The middle ear is actually the connection between the nasopharynx via eustachian tube. So from the nasopharynx to the middle ear, we have a connection. That connection name is eustachian tube. So why do we have an eustachian tube is actually to equalize the pressure between the middle ear and the nose. So continuously the sound waves are hitting the tympanic membrane. In order to equalize that pressure, we have the eustachian tube. For example, in the house, we have only the entrance door. We don't have the windows. What will be there? We can't, the air pressure will be more inside the house if we don't have the windows. The same thing will be substituted by eustachian tube. So the eustachian tube will actually equalize the pressure. Usually the tube will close when we are chewing and swallowing. And when the eustachian tube opens, the air pressure between the outer and middle ear will get equalized. And next, this. So this was the middle ear. So this middle ear, inside the middle ear only, we have the three bones, malleus, incus, tapes. And this is the eustachian tube. And eustachian tube actually will transmit the sound through the eardrum and mainly to equalize the pressure between the outer ear and middle ear. So eardrum, if the pressure is not equalized, what will happen is the eardrum sometimes will break also. And sometimes it will cause the discomfort to transmit the sound. If there is any, for example, if I got cold, severe cold, sometimes the cold will enter into the eustachian tube. So the hearing will be very problematic. We can't hear properly. And ossicular chain. Ossicular chain is the connection of malleus, incus and stapes. And coming to the inner ear, so we have the vestibular apparatus. So the entire inner ear, we call it as labyrinthine apparatus. In the labyrinthine apparatus, we have vestibular apparatus and the cochlea. So the balance part of the ear is referred to as vestibular apparatus. It is composed of 3 semicircular canals. I'll show you in the picture. So this entire thing, we call it as labyrinthine apparatus. So in the labyrinthine apparatus, we have 2 parts. So one is semicircular canals. We call it as vestibular apparatus. In the vestibular apparatus, we have the semicircular canals, okay? And this we call it as cochlea. And inner ear. Inner ear, the vestibular system, mainly why do we have a vestibular system is to maintain the balance between the head and the body. For example, if you close your eyes and make your head to move forward, you can feel that your head is falling towards the ground. For example, if you close your eyes and make your head to move backwards, then you can feel that your head is falling backwards. This feeling is because of vestibular apparatus. So, and this was carried out to the, by eighth cranial nerve. Eighth cranial nerve is vestibulocochlear nerve. And cochlea. Cochlea is the inner hearing part. The main hearing part is cochlea. It will be like a snail. In Greek, cochlea means snail. That's why they named it as cochlea. Coming to the medical terminology, very important thing. Accous. Accous means sound or hearing. Oto. Oto means ear. So, myringo, which is tympanic membrane. Tympano. Tympano means middle ear, tympanic membrane or tympanic cavity. Salpingo, which means eustachian tube. Stapedio or stapedo, which means stapes, the smallest bone in the entire body. Labyrintho, which means labyrinth or inner ear. In the labyrinth only, we have two parts. One is vestibular apparatus, other one is cochlear apparatus. In the vestibular apparatus, semicircular canals is one of the part. And vestibulo means vestibule or vestibular apparatus. Cochleo means cochlea of the inner ear. Audio means hearing. Aurea means discharge. If anything coming out of the ear, like blood, pus, or any fluid, so that you'll have a suffix called aurea. Serum means earwax. So coming to the pathological conditions, labyrinthitis means inflammation of the labyrinth. Mastoiditis, inflammation of the mastoid. Myringitis, inflammation of the tympanic membrane, because myringo means tympanic membrane. Otalgia means pain in the ear. Otomastoiditis, inflammation of the ear along and the mastoid bone, both together. If you have itis as the suffix, which means inflammation. Algia means pain. Otomycosis, if you have myco as the suffix word, myco, which means fungal infection. So, abnormal fungal infection of the ear. Otopyorrhea. Pyo means pus. Orrhea means discharge. So, pus discharge from the ear. We call it as otopyorrhea. Otorrhea. Discharge from the ear. It may be any discharge. Blood, pus or anything else. Otosclerosis. Hardening of the ear. Sclerosis means becoming hard due to some pathology or due to some disease. The ear is becoming hard. Otoacoustic neuroma, which was the benign tumor, so which is particularly to the internal auditory canal. So that internal auditory canal near the hearing nerve, we call it as acoustic nerve, so which will get the tumor. So finally it leads to hearing loss, and that growing the cerebellum also will get damaged. Cerebellum is a part of the brain. Ceruminoma, which means tumor to the gland that secretes the earwax. If you have oma as the suffix, which means tumor. Cholestestoma, which means cyst-like mass, particularly because of epithelial cells. And cholesterol occurring in the middle ear. So it was particularly in the middle ear, may be associated with chronic otitis media. Okay. So chronic means the person is suffering from a long period. Otitis media means inflammation of the middle ear. Meniere's disease. So which is the disease particularly to the inner ear. So the person will have spinning motion. So they'll be feeling like they are moving or their surroundings are moving. So that we call it as Meniere's disease. They'll have a feeling. They'll be telling like I'm moving around or the surroundings are moving around. So they'll have ringing in the ears. They'll be hearing some type of sounds in the ear. That we call it as tinnitus or oral fullness. So if you fill something in your ear, a water or anything, how you will feel? The same thing will be there. That we call it as oral fullness. On fluctuating hearing loss, sometimes they may hear and sometimes they may not hear. Symptoms are always related to change in volume. So they can't hear proper volume. And the composition of fluid within the labyrinth. Otitis externa, which is inflammation of the external ear. Otitis media, inflammation of the middle ear. Perspicuosis, hearing impairment in the old age. Tinnitus, which means ringing in the ear. Vertigo, which is the sense that our body will be moving or the environment will be moving, similar to Meniere's disease. So, if this would be the case, they may be inner ear disease. So, this is actually otitis media. This is normal ear. There is no any fluid here. You can see this yellow color thing is the collection of fluid. So, this is otitis media. The infected fluid in the middle ear. So, this is eardrum. And this was actually the normal picture. This was inflammation. Cochlear implant. If someone has the hearing loss, then they will surgically implant the artificial cochlea. So, which will stimulate the nerve, the auditory nerve, with the help of electric current. Labyrinthectomy. Ectomy means surgical removal. Surgical removal of labyrinth. Mastoidectomy. surgical removal of mastoid bone. Mastoid otomy. Otomy means incision or cut. For example, if the doctor or a surgeon, if they are cutting the part with the help of that knife, that we call it as otomy. Mastoid otomy, incision into the mastoid bone. Myringoplasty. Plasty means surgical repair. Surgical repair of tympanic membrane. Myringotomy, incision into the tympanic membrane. Stapedectomy, surgical removal of the stapes. Tympanoplasty, surgical repair of the middle ear. Audiogram, record of the hearing. So this is actually the tympanoplasty. You can able to see this. This is tympanoplasty. Okay, so there was a hole in the tympanic membrane. And what they will do is they will take some membrane like graft and they will paste it here. So finally, the graft is placed on the hole. They are closing the hole, means they are surgically repairing the hole. Audiometer, instrument used to measure the hearing. Meter means instrument. Audiometry, process of measuring of hearing. Electrocochleography, process of recording the electrical activity of cochlea. Otoscope, any instrument which is used to see inside the body, we call it a scope. Otoscope means instrument to see the visual examination of ear. Otoscopy, visual examination of the ear, the process of visual examination means how they are going to insert, what and all they are going to do, that is otoscopy. Otoscope means that instrument. Tympanometer, instrument used to measure the middle ear functions. Tympanometry, measurement of the tympanic membrane. Audiologist, the person who specialized about hearing. And audiology, study of hearing. And oral, oral means related to the ear. Oto or oral means ear. Cochlea, pertaining to the cochlea. Otologist, person or physician who treats the diseases of the ear. Otology, study of ear. Otorhinolaryngology, which means the person who studies and treats the disease of ear, nose and throat. Oto means ear, rhino means nose, larynx means throat. Vestibular, pertaining to the vestibule or related to the vestibule. Vestibulocochlear, pertaining or related to vestibule and cochlea. AOM, acute otitis media, means inflammation of the middle ear. ENT, ear, eyes, nose and throat. We have ENT and EENT. ENT, ear, nose and throat. OM, otitis media, inflammation of the middle ear. Yeah. That's it. Any doubts related to this topic?
No, ma'am.
Okay. I'll share you the PPT.